that it's quarantine. I'm in the process of doing my hair, so I had to just ignore it. Y'all just ignore it. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep going. If there's one thing that I learned while in those county lines, is that everything takes time. You have gotta lose your pride. You have gotta lose your mind. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. And as you can see by the title, this is going to be an entrepreneur life episode 2 video. And in this video, I'm going to be showing y'all how basically I run my business from my room, which is not a lot of space. I'm going to show you how I organize my stuff, how basically everything runs. And sometimes it might not run smoothly, but I get it done. So without further ado, let's get right into this video. Before we get into this video, I want to give y'all really like a room tour, because that's what this video not about, but I'm going to give y'all kind of like a rundown. Okay? Alright, y'all. So, I'm being extra. I had to start outside my door so y'all get the whole thing. So, can we come in? Yeah. So, alright. As soon as you walk through the door, we get... Don't mind the junk, y'all, but this whole side is my room side. I'm gonna go fast because I don't want y'all to see anything, but y'all see I got some mannequins over there. Got mannequins up there. Then when you turn to this side, you get the work. Okay, so from this side, we got the products that I use for my wigs. And this whole, I have two storage things. I have this one. This storage have, let's open it for y'all, can see it sticking out. But I have some products up here. And this drawer is just dyes, mousse, brushes, combs, gloves, bipin, whatever you could think of. Hairstylist in that drawer. Just call me Hairstylist Brie. In this drawer, I have the wands, the combs, the straighteners, the blow dry, the dye, the gel, the dye bowls. I got more dye in here. I got brush. I got wig caps. All that in there. In this drawer, I have bundles. I try to keep my bundles and like my most ordered bundles in like an easy space for me just coming to get them. So I keep these one right here. These is bundles closest in front to you. Now, the rest of my stock is in these tubes. This bottom tote, these are 613 blind bundles. And this top tote, that is the natural black bundles. When I tell y'all it's a struggle trying to get these bundles out, but that's the one of the cons of running your business from your room. Y'all see my envelopes? I have my envelopes up here. And that's what I got over there. I got my mannequin right here. This is where I do my wigs. This is basically where all the magic happens. I got my display up there. Y'all see my business book right there? I got the hanging out right there. Got some motivation up there. Motivation, baby. All right, y'all, we back. And then at the top, I got my first ever wig up there. This is my baby. I love that wig. Right next to it, I got my tagging gun. Y'all will be seeing that in the video real soon. I got to keep it all the way up there because I have a little sister that stays in my room. My next shelf, I have dyes. I have more in my drawer. But these are the ones that I haven't used yet. The ones in my drawer, they're like half empty, half full, half closed, half da-da-da-da-da. And then we're going to go to my second organizer. I got a chair in front of it. Don't mind that red hair. As y'all know, y'all seen that hair in my hair. I just took it out. It was a sew and I just took it out. I'm about to make it into the wig. That's why I got my whole set up. But right here, this do not stay right here. This usually goes right here. But I'm about to make a wig, so I need to clear my workspace a little bit. But right here, this is where I have my clips. Y'all know my clips. I'm selling the Bossy, the hair clips, Queen, yes, all that is it. These are my silver clips. And if you go down even farther, these are my gold clips. My sexy, these things. Make sure y'all get your $8 clips from queeniedyourhair.com. Shout out to them. Another mostly asked question that I get is how do I like keep basically my bundles from my products? Because of course I wear hair from my business. So how do I separate that? Excuse me. How do I separate that in such a small place? Honestly, I think I make my business and my room work great. I don't mind waking up losing my business. I don't mind it. So the way I do that is 9 times out of 10. Anytime I take out bundles or closures, I normally make it right into the wig. Honestly, that's the best way for me to keep up with it, instead of, because if I don't make it to a wig, it's gonna be in a drawer balled up somewhere. So why not make it to a wig, display it, and 9 times out of 10 I either use these wigs for my photo shoots. I sometimes rewear a lot of my wigs, but for me, the easiest way to keep all my hair separated from you guys' hair, my product, is just to make it into a wig and display it. So all these wigs that you see displayed, these are all my wigs. When I do custom wigs for somebody, I make them and ship them right out. They might hang out for a day or two, but after that, they ship it right out. So majority, any of the wigs you see on my walls or on my mannequins, they're all my wigs, because my clients' wigs do not stay here. I mean, why would they stay here? But I have enough room for my client wigs to stay. But why would they be staying here? So that's how I separate basically my hair. And listen, when you have some bomb hair, you can reuse it. This is Sabrina, okay? Sabrina is rocking my 30-inch water wave. When I tell y'all, I had this wig, not this wig, I had these bundles for probably going on about 2 years, I want to say. And all I have to do is wet this hair, mousse this hair, just play in it, and this wig will come back to life. And I'm still rocking this wig. This is my go-to wig. I don't know what I'm going. If I wake up and need to go somewhere, no, I'll throw this wig on. This will forever be my go-to wig, because when you have good hair, you can reuse it like that. I didn't wear this wig more than I can count, honestly. It's just that simple. So 9 times out of 10, none of these wigs, you can tell none of them is new, because none of them have their clothes on. But a lot of these wigs, my models wore in my photo shoot. A lot of these wigs I wore. All right, we back over here in my second storage with the black bins. So up here, I showed y'all I have where I keep my hair pins. I have my sewing machines, because I'm in the process of learning how to sew my wigs and my units, because it's just making so much faster and so much neater. And it will help me a lot. So I'm in the process of doing this. I have my sewing machine. This is usually my workspace. This is why these bundles are right here, because this is my next project. And I'm definitely going to show you guys how I accomplished this. I'm just going to make these bundles that y'all seen was in my head into a wig. Because like I said before, all my bundles, after I take them out, I make them into a wig. That's how I keep them. And then one day, y'all going to see this wig hanging up on my wall somewhere. So basically, these are bundles that I had took out. But I haven't made them into a wig, because these are bundles that I took out of a ponytail. So, you know, you can't make it into the wig, because these are like 2 bundles and it's no closure or nothing with it. So I might just really end up keeping this hair like this for like ponytails or anything. Anytime I want a ponytail. This is 30 inches. This is 30 inches. Okay, then you know, go down here and I have my conditioners. Of course, you want your alcohol to clean. I have my bleach back there. You can see it. Then, shout out to Nardula. They were actually the first hair business I ever wore. They kind of inspired this. So shout out to Nardula. I still have they box here. This is where I keep like my old pieces. Like pieces I really don't wear no more, but it's good hair, so you don't want to throw in the shirt. This is why I keep it in that box. I have hair curlers in here. It kind of looked messed up because I had this organized for a long time. Like I had this when I was in college. That was some years ago. Down here, this is where I keep more of more bundles and stuff. My go-to, because like I said, I don't want to be digging in them totes and stuff every time I need a bundle. So my most ordered bundles I keep here, and I keep down here in that drawer. Down here is just a whole bunch of nothing. I have some makeup in these drawers. I have some receipts in these drawers. Some shipping labels. I have a whole bunch going on in that drawer. Down here is my cable to my sewing machine. All
right, y'all. So that ends my organization video, I guess we would call it. Basically, I just wanted to give y'all a little flash of how I run everything. And it might not work for you, but it works for me. And I honestly love my job. I love my business. I love what I do. So I had to make it work. That's why I'm expanding for you guys. So don't forget, if you need your bundles, your hair pins, shop Queen Angel Hair. I will have my website down below. I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you later. Keep going, you gotta keep going. If there's one thing that I learned while in those county lines, it's the F.
Everything takes time. You have got